Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. I hope you all are doing great. My name is Zafar and I'm here with one of the recently launched series of our channel named CXO Speak.
I think it's very, very unique initiative on your part and I wish you a great success in this. It's a unique way of really reaching out to people and I'm sure that you're doing a lot of good to a lot of students by putting things which are relevant for them in terms of building a career or identifying or choosing a career. Or even giving a direction to the career sort of a thing. So I think that it's a great job as a student you are doing, and I'm sure that you are helping many of your kind. And besides that, I'm sure that your channel is also being seen by others, just for the general development and personal benefit with respect to gaining more knowledge, perspective, understanding. So I'm pretty happy, and I only I was slightly intrigued when you sent me the invite on LinkedIn. I didn't know Zafar. I don't know you. I have never met you. And I do, with all due humility, we do get a lot of requests from the students from various campuses. And more often than not, you do accept those invites and try to help them. So it was, to a great extent, something on the similar lines. But when I saw your channel, I agreed to talk to you, not because of anything else, but I think that it's a unique initiative, and it makes some sense for sure, other than what other channels might be doing of the placement committees or the students, wherein you reach out to people and do interviews and not really leverage it. So good job and thank you so much. Coming to your question, Zafar, what are the biggest priorities? You tell me, what should be the biggest priority at this point of time, when for last 2 months things are looking so unfavorable for the business, things are looking so bad across the country. Every day we are hearing news. There are two types of news which are covering the newspaper space or the channels. One is overall growth of COVID, and second, how it is impacting people, right? You'll see some channels only talking about the economy. You'll see some channels only talking about migrant laborers, how things are working, how things are not working. And there are channels which are also talking about the spread of the virus and how things are impacting the country and perhaps also forecasting some of the stuff for the future. The common theme across this is that livelihoods are going to be affected across everything, right? Lives people are talking, but livelihoods people are concerned about, right? And as an organization, as a business organization, people do indirectly impact livelihoods of thousands and thousands of people, or people who at least work with that organization. So for the top management and the organizations, clearly objective is how to get back to business, to start off something which has been stopped for last 2 months. Nobody is really bothered that how much time will it take to really scale up, whether it will take 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, but at least vehicle needs to be put back on track. And then let's see that how fast we can ride that vehicle in 1 quarter and 2 quarter and reach to the same speed as we were at before we reached this hump of COVID-19. So I think the biggest priority is to revive the business, start the business and get back to the business. And ensure that at least economy is back on track. So that's the biggest concern and biggest agenda. Agenda also is strategizing and talking about the financials within the company, because it's all about business, right? Companies have cash reserves. Company really are under debt. People go for funding. So Other objective what people are looking at is how to really manage your finances, how to really manage your cash reserves and spend it judiciously, so that when you start the business, you are doing it in the right way. And also you have reserves, keeping in mind how the business will grow up. So these are the two things which I'm sure that organizations are grappling with and senior management is talking about. Yeah.
So right, as you also asked me that what I think that should be the first priority of the company. So most of the time I have heard that if we speak very technically about the business, then most of them have said that the cash flow is really important right now. to manage, because employees in the home at the house, maybe the output is not that great, but they have to manage the human resource as well, because they can't just lay off a lot of them, and you know, have to maintain also the safety of the employees is very important and all things.
Yes.
So the next thing is, you being in the human resource management all of most of your career, what do you think that the, after COVID or mid COVID this crisis, companies are changing their human resource strategies? Are they, of course, they are laying off a lot of times, but many companies, I also heard that they are also hiring, because few industries are also growing on the other hand. So being in the Make My Trip, what do you think that companies are, how they are changing the strategies?
See, I think that in every downturn of economy or upswing of economy, somebody's loss is somebody's gain, right? It is never that everybody gets impacted equally. Yes, in the pandemic like this, you can say this for the first time, at all the industries must have got impacted more or less in the similar manner, right? Everybody's at least to start with is impacted. Now the question is that at what extent they are impacted, right? Some are impacted severely, some are impacted slightly lesser than others, but all of them are impacted. If you look at earlier such downturns, whether it is your 9/11 attack, you had SARS epidemic, some of the industries were impacted, right? Not all of them. In this case, most of the industries are impacted. So that becomes a big concern, that if everyone is impacted, how things will improve. And I'm sure that all those who are also strategic in their thought process, they are doing two things. One, they are ensuring that they are the best of the workforce gets retained, right? So there's a lot of communication happening in all the organizations. Your best of the talent should not really get dissuaded and should not jump the ship. Positive side of that is that, you know, not everybody is also very comfortable jumping the ship, right? While there are people who have who might have resigned, they are also getting second thought that should I really go and take up a new job, or should I continue with my new job? So there are people on both sides, right? There are organizations which are hiring and they will continue to hire. Agro sector is not impacted, right? I think that those people they continue to work. Partial impact would be there may be on a retail industry, e-commerce, you know, partial impact. When I'm saying there's still some of the things are moving. Medical sector has got impacted, but it has not got impacted so severely, right? So there are industries which are hiring. There are industries which are reducing their hiring. But overall, there is definitely a slowdown on the hiring process. Anyone who's saying that, you know, everyone is hiring, I don't think everybody is hiring. Everybody has either stopped their hiring, or they are doing bare minimum hiring, which is very, very important. Many organizations have deferred their joinings for the people. So that's how I look at. And surely organizations are working towards ensuring that their top talent, best talent doesn't move the ship and they continue to be there. And for that, they are doing everything possible.
That's really true, that not everybody is hiring, and bare minimum hiring is there, and it is going to last for the next 1 or 2 years, I guess. It's not going to get to the previous state, I would say, and students are going to their jobs are going to affect. So what would you suggest to the student who is in the last year, just entered the last year, or they are going to graduate right now? So what would you suggest to these students? They really want to hear you.
Zafar, I think there is a formula of 6 L's. L is an alphabet, right? When anybody looks for a job, and when you change a job or you change the role, normally you put that new role or the job or the movement out after the college under these 6 parameters. And these 6 parameters are, first L is location, right? Second L is your level. At what level are you going to join the organization, right? Third is learning. Are you going to learn in the new job or not? Fourth is leaders. Who are the type of people and the leaders you'll be working with, right? Fifth is longevity. Fifth L is longevity, that how far, how long you can stay in that organization. And sixth L is lucre, L-U-C-R-E. Lucre means money. So normally what happens, whenever you get a job, whenever you get an offer, you subconsciously put this, use this framework to take a call, right? I feel that students need to look at this framework, but they need to really prioritize that what is more important than what you, how it used to be some time back, right, pre-COVID. If I say that money used to be very important, I think it should continue to be important, but it should not be as important as your maybe location. Location means where do you want to really go and work? Do you really want to go and work abroad, or you want to be continue to be in India? You want to be closer home, or you want to get stuck when something like this happens for 4 months and 3 months at a place you can't reach home? So I think to some extent, money would remain important, lucre will remain important, but people will start also looking at the location more than anything else. I think also decisions on people are a lot of times taken based on the type of leaders in the organization, which leaders where you join, right? It will be important for you to again look for the organizations wherein you have stalwarts, leaders who can really develop you, groom you, and also take decisions which are not only in the interest of business, but also in the interest of the people who are working. They are not cutthroats. They are not inhumane in terms of a crisis, and they really start laying off people without really giving any cognizance to the personal situation. So I think that you need to, or students need to look for that. Third thing which is important, what I feel is, clearly look at organizations which can leverage your current learnings. If you are an engineer, and if you're a computer science engineer, and you are joining a company after an MBA, which can leverage your computer science learning, please see that you join such organizations, because in that case, you'll be adding additional value to the organization, rather than trying to be completely experimental with your career at this point of time. So that is something which is important, and that is how you should start looking at the career. Other thing what is also important is that as a job, when you look at, mindset has to change for the students in the initial few years. Instead of really splurging money and spending money right, left, center, and being very happy with the fact, yaar, main to jitna kamata hu, utna kharch kar deta hu. Ensure that you develop some amount of saving potential opportunities for yourself in the initial phase of the career. Earlier, it used to happen after 10 years, you should look at that sort of a phase. You get married, then you start looking at savings. But now, I think youngsters will also become very sure that, yeah, I need to create my corpus in the initial phase of my career. Let me look for a job which can give me a good earning potential and also saving potential along with the rest of the things what I talked about, so that I can save money and then perhaps start experimenting. So I think these are some of the things which would completely change, right? We have to also start looking at our own ways of social behaviors. There'll be a lot of change in the social behaviors what will come in. You will have to look at your travel very differently. You'll have to look at entertainment very differently. And when you're looking at a job which you're joining, I think that all these factors you'll have to really look at very, very carefully. How are you going to really get exposed to these areas? So I think for the students, my message is that while your factors will remain same while choosing a career, maybe your priority stack will change a bit, and see that what fits best for you under that formula of six L's what I talk about.
That's really, yes, informative, that the six L formula that a student should know. Most of the students really don't know how to categorize themselves and how to choose exact thing what fits them, and they try to get every opportunity in the campus. It is like they have to win a race. They just don't want to be the last person to in that race and want to grab anything throws at them something. So students now in the crisis, they should choose properly, as just you said, and that is going to give an impact after the after 4 or 5 years. They'll understand how the decision was important. So thank you so much, sir, for your great time that you have given to us. Maybe I have not covered all your thoughts in these three questions as of now. If you want to add anything apart from that, you can definitely do that.
Okay, I think this is good enough. I think things will change. Industry-wise, behavior-wise, things will change. But I'm very sure that it will take time for things to come back. 12 to 18 months. But as Indians, we are very adaptable, right? We are also very high energy, enthusiastic, and things come back very quickly back to normal. Over a period of time, what will happen is after 6 to 8 weeks, COVID-19 and infection around this will become a sort of a normal. People will start having a way of living within this problem. Like when you get onto a road or you go to somebody's place, and in case it's a rainy season, you know how to really walk down to the lane or the road which is full of water puddles and constraints. You start finding your own ways, and you ensure that you don't step into something which can splash water on you. So something on the similar lines, I think we'll have to continue to be careful. We'll have to learn to live with such type of an infection. In a couple of months' time, I think there'll be medication available, so that in case somebody gets affected, I'm sure that person will get treated. 12 to 18 months, there'll be vaccine available. And all these things will happen pretty quickly. But while all this thing goes away, it'll give us a huge learning in terms of how do we start looking at our social behavior? How do we start looking at our relationships? How do we start looking at our travel behaviors? Everything will start changing, and we'll realize that we are far more sober, calibrated in our behavior, in our expectations, in our overall approach towards life. And I think that will be a welcome change what will happen after this. So I think I'm an optimist, and I feel that things will change for better, though it will take some time, but when it will come back, it will come back for better. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for coming to this platform. Have a great day.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thanks a lot, Jafar. Thanks. Yeah. Nice talking to you.
Thank you so much. Yeah. I hope you liked the video. Stay tuned for more such videos. We are going to get more CXOs on board for this particular series, and you are going to get very valuable content out of it. The most of the questions and the answers are related to the crisis that is going on, the lockdown, and how it is going to affect your job, how it is going to affect your career. So stay tuned for this. Click the subscribe button. Do hit the bell icons to get all the notifications. Thank you so much.